Scamper Theatre Kids, Scamper Theatre Kids.
Come act with us and join in our adventure. It's time to sing and dance and play pretend. You can be the star of your own story. Your imagination is a lifelong.
We have one rule. You must be silly.
Repeat after me. I promise. To be super silly.
Super silly.
For this entire class.
Scamper Theatre Kids. Scamper Theatre Kids. Jazz hands.
Now can we have ice cream?
You gotta shake your sillies out, shake your sillies out, wiggle your waggles away. You gotta giggle your giggles out. You gotta giggle your giggles out. You gotta giggle your giggles out. And wiggle your waggles away. You gotta skip your skippies out. You gotta skip your skippies out. You gotta skip your skippies out. And wiggle your waggles away. You gotta sneeze your sneezies out. You gotta sneeze your sneezies out. You gotta sneeze your sneezies out. And wiggle your waggles away. You gotta shake your sillies out. Shake your sillies out. Shake your sillies out. And wiggle your waggles away. Okay, so Brooke is gonna show you a picture of something, and then you are gonna try to be what's on that picture, and then I am gonna guess what you are being. Are you ready? Let's go. Are you a lobster? Oh, okay, you know, lobster. Claws. You're a lobster. Are you a clam? Close? Okay. Are you a crab? Okay, next up. Vacuum cleaner? No, okay, that's a bad guess, I guess. All right, are you a chair? Next up. Okay. Are you flossing? Are you doing the floss? Are you a dancer? No, okay. Are you a submarine? Are you a boat? Yes! You guys are amazing boats! Nice playing.
say go to sleep, you're gonna go to sleep. And then I'm gonna sprinkle my magic sleeping potion on top of you. And when I say wake up, you will magically transform into whatever. And I turn you into. Go to sleep. Okay, for this first one, I just realized we've been playing this game for so many weeks together and I have yet to turn you into bunnies! Wake up and turn into little bunnies hopping through the forest. Do, 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 do. How do bunnies hop? Yeah! Bunny faces. Yes, good little sleeping bunnies. And go to sleep, go to sleep. All right, now it's about to get a little bit scary in here. When the lights go on, I want to see you turn into a big, scary, furry, grizzly bear. Hibernation. Let me see you move. Are you big? Are you scary? Are you hungry? Eat everything. You've been in hibernation. Yes, keep going, my scary fuzzy bears. And go to sleep, go to sleep, go to sleep. And now, we are heading to the woods, where I would like to see you, a nocturnal bird. Any guesses? Yes, let me see you transform into an owl. Ooh, ooh, ooh. How do owls speak? Ooh, ooh, and they have really big eyes, right? This one's my favorite one because when the lights turn on, you will magically transform into sweet, adorable, wonderful little children! It's story time! This week, we have a wonderful book for you called A Piece of Cake by LeUyen Pham. Thanks! Now, I want you to pay attention to this story because, of course, when we're done reading it, we are going to act it out and turn it into a play. But first, the author of our book has something special to say to you.
Hi, I'm LeUyen Pham. Actually, I'm LeUyen Pham's cartoon double. The real LeUyen Pham is still in her pajamas, drinking her coffee, and she's got her morning face on and doesn't really want to be filmed. Every time she feels that way, she sends me in. So here I am to introduce the book that she, well, that I, wrote and illustrated called A Piece of Cake. It sounds like you guys are going to be performing it now, so we're both really excited to see how this turns out. Can't wait to see!
It was Little Bird's birthday. Mouse, who was a very kind mouse, made her a cake. He worked the whole morning through and used up everything in his pantry. Mouse began to walk to Little Bird's home. On the way, he met Chicken sitting with all her eggs. "Hello, Chicken," said Mouse. Chicken said, "Yummers, that's one tasty looking cake. Hey, Mouse, could I have some? If you give me a piece of cake, I'll trade you a cork." "A cork? Sure, just think of all the things you can use it for." Mouse didn't think Little Bird would need a cork, but Mouse was a very kind mouse. Surely Little Bird would not mind if I gave Chicken some of her cake. So Mouse traded one piece of cake for the cork and went on his way. Next, Mouse met Squirrel, who was gathering nuts. "Hello, Squirrel," said Mouse. Squirrel said, "Gadzooks, that's one tasty looking cake. Mouse, old buddy, how about giving me some? If you give me a piece of cake, I'll trade you a wire." "A wire? Oh yeah, just think of all the things you can do with a wire. Mouse couldn't imagine that Little Bird would need a wire. But Mouse was a very kind mouse. Surely Little Bird would not mind if I gave Squirrel some of her cake. So Mouse traded one piece of cake for the wire and went on his way. Soon Mouse met Bear, surrounded by his many pots of honey. Hello, Bear, said Mouse. Bear said, wowzers, that's one tasty looking cake. Mouse, my fine little fellow, would you mind giving me some? If you give me a piece of cake, I'll trade you a net. A net? Sure, a net. You can always use a net, I tell you. Mouse was sure that Little Bird did not want a net, but Mouse was a very kind mouse. Surely Little Bird would not mind if I gave Bear some of her cake. So Mouse traded one piece of cake for the net and went on his way. Further on, Mouse met Cow, who was surrounded by bottles of milk.
Hello, Cow, said Mouse. Cow said, holy cow, that cake looks good. Mouse, my dear, may I have some? If you give me a piece of cake, I'll trade you a fly swatter.
A fly swatter?
Yup, a fly swatter. Nothing more useful than a fly swatter. Mouse knew that Little Bird would not want a fly swatter, but Mouse was a very kind mouse. Surely Little Bird would not mind if I gave Cow some of her cake. So Mouse traded the last piece of cake for the fly swatter and went on his way. Finally, he reached Little Bird's house. Oh, Little Bird, I wanted to bring you a cake for your birthday, but I traded the pieces of cake for a cork, a wire, a net, and a fly swatter. I would make you another cake, but I've used up everything in my pantry. I'm so sorry. But Little Bird, who was a very clever bird, said, oh, but Mouse, these are wonderful presents. Come with me, and I'm sure we'll find a use for them. First, they met Cow. What's wrong, Cow? Asked Mouse. I lost the cap to my soap bottle. If only I had something to cork it up with. Well, said clever little bird, Cow, my dear, if you give us some milk, we'll give you a wire.
A wire?
Yes, for blowing your bubbles with your soap. And little bird twisted the wire into a loop, dipped it into the soap, and blew bubbles.
Wow, said Cow.
So Cow traded the milk for the wire, and Mouse and little bird went on their way. Next, they met Bear. What's wrong, Bear? Asked Mouse.
These bees won't leave me alone. If only I had something to swat them away with.
Well, said clever little bird, Bear, my fine fellow, if you give us some honey, we'll give you a cork.
A cork?
Yes, to close up the hole of the hive so the bees can't come out. And little bird popped the cork into the hive to keep the bees from coming out.
Excellent, said Bear.
So Bear traded the honey for the cork, and Mouse and Little Bird went on their way. Soon, they ran into Squirrel.
What's wrong, Squirrel? Asked Mouse.
I can't get the nuts into the tree. If only I had something to carry them up with.
Well, said clever little bird,
Squirrel, my friend, if you give us some nuts, we'll give you a fly swatter.
A fly swatter?
Yes, you can use it as a catapult to throw your nuts into your nest. And little bird bent the fly swatter in the ground, loaded it with nuts, and let it go. The nuts flew through the air and landed in the net.
Cool, said Squirrel.
So Squirrel traded some nuts for the fly swatter, and Mouse and little bird went on their way. Finally, they met Chicken. What's wrong, Chicken?
I dropped the piece of cake Mouse gave me. Oh, if only I had another piece to eat.
Oh, dear.
Well, said kind Mouse, Chicken, dear Chicken, if you give us some eggs, we'll give you an invitation.
An invitation?
Yes, to Little Bird's birthday party. With your eggs, Squirrel's nuts, Bear's honey, and Cow's milk, we can make another cake. Invite everyone, and we can each have a piece of cake.
Yay, said Chicken.
So Chicken traded two eggs for the invitation and ran off to tell the others. And Mouse and Little Bird went on to Mouse's home. Mouse and Little Bird worked all that afternoon, and together they made a cake that looked and tasted even better than the first one. After everyone was given a piece, Mouse gave Little Bird one last present.
You're such a clever mouse, and you're such a kind little bird.
You want to
play a piece of cake.
I do want to do the play a piece of cake. Yay! Okay, so how does the play start?
No, you have to do it.
No, I thought you were going to be in charge this time.
I want you to be in charge.
Oh, secret handshake time. Woof, woof, go team. Oh.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
No, wait, I have an idea.
Okay, how's it go this time? Okay, so I think that we should play the parts of Mouse and Little Bird. It's the day of Little Bird's birthday, so we are gonna be the mouse. Okay.
I'm a little mouse. Okay.
How does a mouse move?
Oh, it's Little Bird's birthday. I think that we should bake him a cake. Okay, what do we need? Let's look in the pantry for ingredients. Can everybody help look for some ingredients? Throw me some if you got them. Thank you very much. Got the ingredients. Okay, let's stir it together. What do we need? A little, we got some sugar.
Sugar.
Sugar, a little sugar, butter, flour.
Mix it up together. Okay, okay, okay. Can you help mix?
Put it in the oven.
Put it in the oven. Okay, let's open the oven. Shh, everybody open up your ovens and put the ingredients in. Oh, we did it. Yay. Oh, let's see. Oh, the timer just went off. Look. You made a beautiful cake. It looks so good. Can I smell it? Can I smell your cake? Oh, it smells so good. I can't wait to take it to Little Bird. All right, all my little mice, let's go on our journey and look for Little Bird. Bloop, 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 do. Oh, I see somebody in the distance. Who is that? Oh, who is that?
Chicken.
It's chicken. What do you need?
Yummers. That cake looks tasty.
Okay, sure. Let's give him a piece of cake.
Thank you.
Okay. Everybody say bye, chicken.
Bye, chicken.
Oh, wait. What do I see in the distance? Who's that? Is that our squirrel friend? Okay, everybody say, hi, squirrel.
Hi, squirrel.
Okay, let's give him some cake.
Here. Why, thank you.
Okay, bye, squirrel. Okay, let's go.
What a lovely day it is outside. The sun is shining. The birds are tweeting. It's a wonderful day.
Oh, who's that in the distance? Everybody say, hi, bear.
Hi, bear.
What are you doing here?
Whoa, that's really tasty cake.
Let's give him a piece of cake.
Thank you.
Okay, bye, bear. Everybody say bye, bear. Bye, have a good day. Okay, let's go see Little Bird, everybody. I'm so excited to see Little Bird. Oh, who is that in the distance?
Cow.
Oh, it's Cow. Everybody say hi, Cow.
Hi, Cow.
Okay, give me your last piece. Bye, Cow. Okay.
We have no more cake.
Well, let's just go talk to Little Bird. I'm sure Little Bird will be reasonable. Okay, and now I want everybody to turn into a little bird. So can I see you fly like a bird? Yes, that's a very good bird. Little Bird, we have a bit of a problem. We gave all of our cake away. What do you think we should do? Huddle up, come close. I think we have a plan. We have to go back, get all of our animal friends, and see if they'll trade us some of their ingredients so we can make a new cake?
Yeah.
What do you think? Okay. Guys, everybody, girls, guys, friends, huddle up. I need Cow to come back over here. Squirrel, bear, and chicken. I need you all. Come here. We're gonna huddle up. Huddle up. Huddle up. Everybody huddle up. We need a group meeting. Group meeting. Here's the deal. We're gonna need some things back to make that cake. So can you please give us chicken? I need an egg. Thank you. I need bear. can we please have some honey? Squirrel, can we please have some nuts? And cow, can we please have some milk? Thank you, we got it! Okay, do you have everything in your hands? Make sure you're carrying all the ingredients in your hands. Now that you have all the ingredients, would you like to come to Little Bird's birthday party? Okay, let's go, grab your ingredients. Let's go inside the house and everybody, let's start mixing. Mix everything together, mix. Faster, really whip it into, really, mix the ingredients. Do what you do however you bake. I think that's how you bake, right? Yeah, bake, roll it. That seems right. And then what, we put it in the oven? Okay, everybody, put your cake in the oven. Let's put it in. And everybody, this is the fun part. Let's wait. Cake's ready, let's open up the oven. Everybody open up your ovens. You baked a beautiful cake. It's wonderful, so I think we should sing happy birthday to little bird. Hey, bear, could you help us out?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, little bird. Happy birthday to you.
Now it's time to make a wish. Close your eyes really tight. Think of something you really, really want. And blow out the candle. You did it! Happy birthday! Now it's party time! We're at the party! And you just did the play a piece of cake. So everybody, I need you to take a big, big bow!
Yay!
Oh, and groan curtsy. Yes.
Groan curtsy.
Oh, wonderful, marvelous. Blow kisses to the audience. Oh, you're marvelous, dear. You're marvelous. Thank you. And one more big bow. Bravo. The audience love you. They're mad about you. Get your flowers. Fabulous.
Wow, that was pretty cool. You guys are really good actors, and you look like you're having a lot of fun. Thanks so much for reading my book, and I hope I see you sometime soon. Bye.
Guess what time it is?
Dance party.
So put on your dancing shoes. It's time to dance.
Okay. I'm gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive.
Explode!
time. I'm having a ball.
Don't stop me now.
If you wanna have a good time, just give me a call.
Don't stop me
Try
now.
I'm having a good time.
Don't stop
yes,
me
I'm
now.
I'm having a good time. I
don't wanna stop at all.
Da 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 da.
Yes, it's our imagination box of surprises. Last week, you took home something a little ooey and gooey, a snail. Okay, so this week, we are gonna take home something a little bit crittery crawlery. Do you have a guess? It is something from the book that we read this week, a piece of cake. We are going to take home a mouse. I know, normally when you have a mouse in the house, it's not a great thing, but it's gonna be so fun because they're so cute, right? If you have a cat in your house, you should probably hide the mouse. Okay, get ready. It's so cute. Okay, the thing with mice, they like to eat cheese. So if you wanna give them a little piece of cheese, they like to scamper about. You like to scamper about too, don't you? Okay. So I'm gonna pick up, it's moving all over. Okay, put your hand out. I'm going to give you this mouse. It's really cute. Get your hands ready, Oh! Okay, so as I told you, mice like to scamper about, so you should build a little home for your mouse, maybe a box. Could you find a little box to put your mouse in? Sneak a little cheese, like maybe when you're having dinner, you can sneak a little piece of cheese for your mouse. Yes, of course, name your mouse. And most importantly, have fun and love your mouse this week. Now, before we leave, I need you to repeat after me. I am special. I am creative. I am kind. I am fun. I am silly. I am important. And my favorite one, I am me. Yes, because you are the only you. And that is why I love you so much. For being a part of our Scamper Theatre Kids family. We love you, we really do, and we feel like through this whole experience we've gained this whole new online Scamper Theatre Kids family, so thank you. Thank you for the messages and the emails and the videos of your kids dancing. Keep sending those. We love the videos of your kids dancing and taking class. And of course, please send this to your friends. We want as many kids as possible to enjoy class. We will release a new class every Saturday morning, and as always, this class is free. But if you're able to donate a couple of dollars to our Venmo, we do appreciate that, as we will be sending 50% of those proceeds each week to a new charity. This week, we will be sending that money to Teach for America, which helps to provide fabulous education to all children, especially focused on those in lower income communities. Right now, during the pandemic, they want to help supplies for children that might not have them, such as computers and things that kids need during this remote learning. So we really want to help them out. Thank you so much from our family to yours. We love you so much. Keep dancing, and we will, of course, see you next week.
Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you will join us. then the world will be all this one.